Good afternoon, and welcome to our winter concert of the North Oakland Concert Band. My name is Mark Buchanan. I'm a member of the trumpet section and the president of the band, and I'd like to welcome you here this afternoon. The title of our concert today is South of the Border, and we will feature music from Mexico and Spain. A few housekeeping items. As you came in, you passed the restrooms. They're back out to the right when you go out. Hopefully you saw our CD and donation table. If you'd like to make a donation to the band, it's tax deductible, and we very much would appreciate it. It helps to allow us to bring you these concerts free of charge. We also have a website that you can visit, www.nocb.org. You can sign up to be on our mailing list there, as well as get more information about the band. So before we get started, make sure you silence your cell phones, shut them off if needed. And then I will introduce the first piece, which is called Amparita Rocco. The origins of Amparita Rocco are not exactly known, but it was copyrighted and published by Jamie Texidor in 1935. Like many other pieces written by Texidor, this is a pasodoble, which means a double-step Spanish dance. And traditionally, pasodobles are played at bullfights while the bullfighter is entering the arena. So let's get started, and please welcome our conductor, Annette Klein.
Good afternoon. I'm Robin Myers, and I'll be the program moderator for the rest of your afternoon. We're so glad that you could join us, and it gives us great pleasure to bring out all our Mexican, Spanish, and Latin music for this concert. I'm sure you will appreciate all of the pieces. Composed in spring 2003, Bayou Breakdown was written for the University of Toledo Wind Ensemble and dedicated to Frank Wicks, director of bands at Louisiana State University. Brant Carrick's initial idea was to compose a fugue for concert band blending elements of American bluegrass with a sort of Bach meets Percy Grainger sound. As is the case with many compositions, the piece was at least halfway sketched before it received its title. Breakdown in this case refers to a lively, sometimes noisy, and highly energetic American country dance. Adding Bayou to the title allowed the composer to reflect upon his many cherished memories of the charismatic state of Louisiana and Louisiana State University, and encouraged him to include rhythms and harmonies heard in certain Cajun music. In the end, Bayou Breakdown weaves a bluegrass reel into a fugal texture with plenty of Cajun two-step backbeats and blue notes. We hope you enjoy this palate-pleasing musical gumbo.
Thank you.
La Fiesta Mexicana, subtitled Mexican Folk Song Symphony for Concert Band, is a work written after composer Owen Reed received a Guggenheim Fellowship for study in Mexico for 6 months in 1948 to 1949. While there, he heard Mexican music from the many different cultures that make up the country's heritage, including Aztec, Roman Catholic, and mariachi music. The work depicts a religious festival dedicated to the Blessed Virgin Mary and faithfully represents all of the contrasts and contradictions of these festivals. It is both serious and comical, festive and solemn, devout and pagan, boisterous and tender. The prelude in Aztec dance, the first movement, is you'll hear the tumbling of church bells and midnight fireworks that signal the opening of the fiesta. Groups of Mexicans from near and far slowly descend on the huge court surrounding the old cathedral, and after a brave effort of gaiety, the celebrators settle down on their serapes to a restless night until the church bells and fireworks again intrude at dawn. A band is heard in the distance, and then in the plaza, attention turns to the frenetic Aztec dancers wearing plumes and masks. The mass, you will hear the tolling of bells, reminding that the fiesta is, after all, a religious celebration. Rich and poor slowly gather within the walls of the old cathedral for contemplation and worship. And finally, the last movement, the carnival. Passion governs the love, hate, and joy of the mestizo and the indio. There is entertainment for young and old. The circus, the market, the bullfight, the town band, and always the cantinas with their band of mariachis. And just a fun fact about Owen Reed. He was an American composer, conductor, and author, and he has a tie to the state of Michigan. He was professor of music and head of composition at Michigan State University from 1939 all the way to 1976. And he's serving since then as professor emeritus until his death. He played jazz in college and beyond his 100th year in a Michigan State faculty combo known as the Geriatric Six. Ladies and gentlemen, this work is in three movements, so we ask that you hold your applause until the end of the final movement. And now, Owen Reed's most acclaimed musical masterpiece, La Fiesta Mexicana.
Thank you.
Welcome back to our second half. Hopefully you enjoyed that last one, Fiesta Mexicana. It was a doozy for us to prepare, but what an incredible piece of music. Composer Zequina Abreu was born in Sao Paulo, Brazil. A musician from an early age, he composed nearly 100 works by the age of 25. In 1917, his orchestra played his new composition, still unnamed, and at a ball. The jumpy, fast-tempo song made the dancing couples go crazy. Abreu observed that those people looked just like tico-ticos, a kind of little bird eating cornmeal, which is the meaning of the song's eventual name, Tico-Tico no Fuba, Sparrow in the Cornmeal. The song became popular in the early 1940s in Brazil and in the U.S., where it was sung by Carmen Miranda in the 1947 film with Groucho Marx, Copacabana. It was also included in a movie by Walt Disney. Please enjoy our second half opener, Tico Tico, by Zequina Abreu. Please welcome Annette Klein back to the stage. Haunting and captivating, describe John Williams' soundtrack to the caper hit film Catch Me If You Can, featuring Leonardo DiCaprio and Tom Hanks. John Williams, a frequent collaborator with the movie's director Steven Spielberg, has composed a score in the idiom of progressive jazz prevalent in the 50s and 60s. The music features an alto sax soloist and a wide variety of unique percussion and scoring devices. Joining us today to play this superb arrangement of the whimsical suspense movie score is NOCB's own alto saxophonist Ian Herbon. Currently working for McCourt's Musical Instruments, Ian works as an instrument repair assistant, private instructor, and sales associate. He holds a degree from Eastern Michigan University, where he played in both large and small ensembles, the marching band, and served as the saxophone mentor for the Detroit Symphony Orchestra Civic Wind Ensemble during his senior year. Ian continued his study of music and went on to attend Ithaca College and earned a Master of Music in saxophone performance. While there, he performed in the Wind Ensemble, Jazz Repertoire Ensemble, the Cayuga Saxophone Quartet, and played both electric and double bass in multiple musical theater productions. Ian devotes his time to constant practicing and teaching undergraduate students in the area of woodwind performance, and is dedicated to sharing his knowledge and skills with young musicians to help them achieve their musical aspirations. Let's give a warm welcome to Ian Herbon as he lends his jazzy colors to John Williams' score of Catch Me If You Can. And Annette Klein, please welcome her back. Thank you. It always gives us great pleasure to feature one of our talented musicians in our own band. So once again, a big hand for Ian Hervine. What a great job. Danzas Cubanas is a set of three original dance-like movements celebrating the joy and energy of Afro-Cuban music and the people of this island nation. The upcoming conga sets the mood, followed by a gentle and alluring son salsa. The closing dance is a fast-paced mambo, an excellent multicultural musical experience. The three interconnected dances were commissioned by the band directors of the Florida Bandmasters Association 14th District in Palm Beach County in memory of their dear friend and fellow band director, Ubaldo Montesino. Hold on to your hats, ladies and gentlemen, as we present this fiery celebration of sound that will for sure bring you to your feet. Guaranteed, this one is hot. I told you that one was hot. We close our concert today with El Camino Real, literally translated to the Royal Road or the King's Highway. It was commissioned by and is dedicated to the 581st Air Force Band and its commander, Lieutenant Colonel Ray E. Toler. Composed during the latter half of 1984 and completed in early 85, it bears the subtitle A Latin Fantasy. The legend of El Camino Real and its bells is actually quite interesting. At the same time that the American colonies were rebelling against England, a coalition of Spaniards and Mexicans established outposts up the California coast. A footpath called the El Camino Real, or King's Highway, was created to connect these outposts. As time progressed and more missions were built, the footpath became a roadway wide enough to accommodate horses and wagons. Overall, El Camino Real linked 21 missions, pueblos, and 4 presidios from San Diego all the way to the Sonoma Valley. Alfred Reed was one of America's most prolific and frequently performed composers, with more than 200 published works for concert band, wind ensemble, orchestra, chorus, chamber ensemble. The composition, El Camino Real, is based on a series of chord progressions common to countless generations of Spanish flamenco guitarists, which have become synonymous with what we feel to be the true Spanish idiom. We hope you've enjoyed our musical journey south of the border today and hope to see you at our next event, which is our second seasonal fundraiser scheduled for Sunday, March 19th at 4 p.m. at the Orion Community Center on Joslyn Road. Hope to see you there. Please welcome Annette back to the stage.